The Raptor 3 engine has emerged as a formidable contender in the space rocket industry, with unmatched power output that surpasses the capabilities of any other operational rocket engine in the world. What about a more substantial variant? If the Raptor 3 demonstrated such impressive power, one has to wonder how much more powerful the Raptor Vacuum 3 will be. Recently, SpaceX has revealed an early glimpse of this new iteration. Let's discuss more in today's episode of NR Studio. The Raptor engine has undergone notable advancements from the Raptor 1 to the Raptor 3, showing improvements in thrust, specific impulse, ISP, mass efficiency, and reusability. It is expected that the Raptor Vacuum will also undergo comparable evolution and improvement. While a full official reveal of the Raptor Vacuum 3 has yet to occur, recent photos observed outside of the SpaceX facility show that the latest iteration of the Raptor Vacuum appears to be much sleeker and more compact, indicating less complex plumbing than its predecessor. The Raptor Vacuum 3 is engineered similarly to its predecessor, the original R-Vac, which was specifically optimized for spaceflight, featuring an enlarged nozzle to improve operational efficiency. The elongated nozzle on the original Raptor Vacuum achieved an impressive expansion ratio of 200, requiring a nozzle diameter of approximately 1 meter. Given this, it makes sense that the R-Vac 3 would offer a more substantial expansion ratio. However, Starship's 9-meter diameter places constraints on nozzle size, which would likely result in the ISP remaining below its theoretical maximum of 386 seconds. A compromise between specific impulse, ISP, thrust, and mass could ultimately emphasize improving overall vehicle performance. Nonetheless, contemporary R-Vac models exhibit an impressive thrust capacity of 357 tons, along with an astonishing specific impulse of up to 380 seconds in a vacuum environment. With its exceptional thrust and efficiency, the R-Vac significantly outperforms many competitors, including the vacuum variant of the BE engine, which has an ISP of 339 seconds. The RD-180 has an impressive specific impulse, ISP, of 338 seconds when operating in a vacuum. The Space Shuttle's famous RS-25 engine achieved an impressive specific impulse of 52 seconds, albeit exclusively through its innovative dual combustion chamber configuration. Undoubtedly, vacuum engines consistently achieve superior specific impulses, ISP, compared to engines at sea level. In a vacuum, the absence of atmospheric pressure means there is no counteracting force acting on the exhaust gases, unlike at sea level, where atmospheric drag inhibits efficiency. For example, SpaceX Falcon 9 launches use Merlin engines, which achieve impressive specific impulses of 282 seconds at sea level and about 311 seconds in a vacuum. It makes sense that the Raptor Vacuum 3 exhibits greater power than its sea level counterpart, the Raptor 3. Ultimately, the RVAC 3 aims to incorporate the Raptor 3 advanced design principles to improve efficiency and reusability, marking a significant advance over the original RVAC. While there are certain uncertainties, these estimates are consistent with SpaceX's iterative development strategy and its lofty goals. But is this the peak for SpaceX? Of course not. In fact, Elon Musk's aspirations go even further than that. In his recent speech, the forward-thinking CEO alluded to an ambitious goal, the advancement of the Raptor. As a result, this inherently points to the development of the upcoming R-Vac. This is truly commendable. It is hard to imagine what further achievements they might achieve. Nevertheless, they continue to thoroughly research and test each iteration of the Raptor engine, gaining invaluable experience with each iteration. The company will continue to improve and evolve its design. Future iterations of the engine may incorporate advanced materials, improved cooling mechanisms, and refined fuel mixtures to further enhance performance and efficiency. SpaceX is engaged in a continuous process of improving their engine technology. Their production rate is also remarkable. During the initial period from February 2018 to 2021, which lasted about 36 months, SpaceX managed to produce about 100 Raptor 1 engines. This equates to an average of one engine produced every 11 days. However, after the transition to Raptor 2, the production rate skyrocketed. In 2021, Elon Musk revealed that their production capacity allows for one engine every 8 hours. That statement seems reasonable enough. Raptor 2 production began in late 2021, And remarkably, in just 11 to 12 months, in November 2023, SpaceX proudly unveiled a photo showing off their 200th completed Raptor engine. NASA has also confirmed that SpaceX has achieved an incredible production rate, producing one engine every 2 hours. Remarkably, in just over a year, their total engine count appears to have skyrocketed, effectively doubling. This number is poised for substantial growth, especially considering that each spacecraft requires 35 engines, not including the prospect of a larger prototype that could require as many as 39 engines. 400 engines may seem like a substantial number. However, it is only enough for about 10 complete spacecraft. The Raptor engines are poised to attract even more attention as we approach some of Starship's major upcoming launches. After 8 flights, the Raptor engines have seen significant improvements. However, additional launches are critical to achieving the reliability that SpaceX aspires to. The successful advancement of the Raptor engine paves the way for unprecedented opportunities for SpaceX and the future of space exploration. The company has been awarded a contract by NASA to build a variant of Starship intended for lunar landings. As part of the Artemis program, which aspires to facilitate a human return to the moon by 2026. The Raptor engine, specifically the Raptor Vacuum variant, is poised to play an integral role in facilitating Starship's ascent and descent to the lunar surface. A comparison of SpaceX Raptor engine with the RS-25 engine used by SLS reveals that the Raptor engine demonstrates far superior performance. The RS-25 engine uses liquid hydrogen, LH2, as its fuel source and liquid oxygen, LOX, as its oxidizer. It produces an impressive thrust of over 500,000 pounds and has a specific impulse of 52 seconds in a vacuum, making it one of the most efficient engine and propellant combinations ever built. However, the synergy of methane and liquid oxygen, LOX, presents several advantages over liquid hydrogen, LH2, and LOX for the mission SpaceX envisions for Starship. Methane is denser than liquid hydrogen, LH2, occupying less volume for the same energy output. This implies that the rocket can be more compact, leading to less drag on the booster stage as it ascends through Earth's dense lower atmosphere. Furthermore, the SLS rocket has earned a reputation as a financial black hole, drawing considerable attention from the aerospace sector. However, launching a system that consistently exceeds its budget constraints is no easy feat, and Starship, along with privately developed rockets, may continue to be considered NASA's undecided choice. Despite these dynamics, SpaceX and its aerospace systems continue to be an integral element of NASA's operational paradigm and the broader U.S. aerospace industry. This is due to the fact that many countries around the world are quickly positioning themselves as formidable competitors in the burgeoning space race. In January 2019, China achieved a historic milestone by successfully landing its first spacecraft on the far side of the moon. The country aspires to build a lunar base in the coming decade, with plans to deploy a telescope boasting a field of view 3,000 times that of Hubble. China has also set its sights on Mars. It's not hard to find perspectives warning that the United States could once again be left behind in the space race. In August 2022, the Pentagon estimated that China could surpass the U.S. space capabilities in as little as 20 years. And it's worth noting that China isn't the only country advancing its space initiatives. The United Arab Emirates achieved a remarkable milestone by becoming the fifth nation to reach Mars with its Hope probe. India recently distinguished itself as the fourth nation to successfully land on the moon, and notably the first to do so near the lunar South Pole. To maintain its lead, NASA will need to successfully facilitate the return of humans to the moon for the first time in more than half a century, with the success of this endeavor largely dependent on the Artemis missions. The rapid progress of Starship could alleviate some of NASA's concerns about this mission, provided NASA maintains its collaborative efforts and trust in SpaceX. Establishing America's first lunar base is indeed a worthy goal. A lunar base could evolve into a refueling hub for deep space expeditions, significantly increase the likelihood of human life on Mars, and contribute to unraveling the lingering scientific puzzles surrounding the formation of the Earth and Moon. It has the potential to catalyze a thriving space economy, potentially centered around lunar space tourism. However, the Moon, a celestial body 4-5 billion years old, should be considered a hazardous environment for humans and should not be ignored or treated lightly. Its surface is littered with craters and rocks, which pose significant risks to a safe landing. A more pressing issue, however, is the formation of regolith, commonly called moon dust, caused by meteorite impacts over millions of years. In 201, Amadou Thangabalu, an aerospace engineer at the University of Southern California, described the moon's surface as being covered in a thin layer of lunar dust reminiscent of talcum powder, with some areas showing a depth of several inches. This dust, electrostatically charged through interaction with the solar wind, is highly abrasive and sticky, leading to accelerated degradation of spacesuits, vehicles, and various systems. Peggy Whitson, an astronaut with 665 days of cumulative spaceflight experience, has previously spoken about the significant challenges posed by dust during the Apollo missions. The issue of sunlight also needs to be considered. For roughly a day, the lunar surface is a scorching inferno under the sun's relentless radiation, with no atmospheric shield for protection. The next 2 weeks are shrouded in total darkness, making the lunar surface one of the coldest locations in the solar system. Because of its greater distance from Earth, SpaceX has consistently focused its ambitions on Mars exploration. The company's ambitious long-term vision aims to build a self-sustaining city on Mars, with Raptor engines serving as the primary propulsion system driving this bold endeavor. Its ability to utilize methane as a fuel source, derived from native Martian resources, makes it highly advantageous for extended missions and on-site resource utilization. Beyond their basic mission, Starship and its Raptor-powered Super Heavy boosters have the potential to fundamentally change the launch industry. Its fully reusable architecture and rapid turnaround potential have the potential to significantly lower the costs associated with space access, making a wider range of payloads feasible, such as satellites, space telescopes, and interplanetary spacecraft. SpaceX is actively investigating the potential for Starship to facilitate point-to-point travel across the Earth. By leveraging the vehicle's capacity for suborbital flights, the company anticipates a future where passengers could traverse vast distances between cities in a matter of minutes. While currently in the conceptual stages, the success of this implementation will depend largely on the efficacy and reliability of the Raptor engine. In other words, the Raptor can be likened to the compact embodiment of SpaceX itself. Streamlining the concept to increase its power may seem easy. However, in practice, it has proven to be extremely challenging. However, it is that signature formula that has driven the success of SpaceX, the world's leading aerospace company. Using the same formula, the Raptor engine is pushing the boundaries of aerospace technology to incredible new heights. That's it for today's episode. See you in the next episode, and thank you for your support.